the test format, which I have up here in the content library. So some test details, you should be able to list all the possible rational zeros for a polynomial function, determine the total number of zeros for a polynomial function, use the limit notation to describe the end behavior for a polynomial function, use your calculator to find and identify local and global mins and maxes, use your calculator to find all the real zeros, given a polynomial function to determine if all the real zeros lie on an interval, write a polynomial function with the given zeros and leading coefficient, and then algebraically to find all the zeros for a polynomial function. So these are all things that we've done. So like this part we did in the homework quiz, right? You guys should remember doing that. This is a homework problem, like I think 34 and 35 we did that in the homework. This is another homework question, I think 13 through 14 and like 36 or something, 40, I don't remember, somewhere in that neck of the woods. Let me find my sheets here. Nope, that's not the right sheet. This is the right sheet. Too many sheets. My desk is full of sheets. Ha 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 ha. 44 through 47, and then the back page of worksheet 1 were all those kinds of problems. Algebraically to find all the zeros for a polynomial function, that's the last topic that we've been working on. So like 36 through 43, 48 through 53 from the homework are all kind of doing that. And then these guys are really just parts of the process we would do for finding all the zeros for a polynomial, right? When we make our list of possible rational zeros, that also happens. We do that every time we try to solve one of these polynomials algebraically or determine the total number of zeros. That's a step that we use when we're solving algebraically. So like, questions about like what's going to be on the test there? Landon?
Is there any way to get like our homework quiz back just like look over it before the test?
Probably. Let me, give me a minute to kind of sort through the rest of the stuff, but we can see what we can do there. I think I have them ready to go. Okay. Today then, are there any like content or homework questions? If you change your mind and come up with something later, that's fine. You can always come up and talk to me later, not a big deal. Victoria?
So for the one that like 36 to 43, uh-huh. Just says like the final zero function.
Yep.
But then like the ones that are 48 to 53. It says like what's the difference?
The only difference is the direction in 48 through 53. It has one additional piece of direction. It says, if any zeros are repeated, state the multiplicity of that zero.
Well, like to find the zeros.
The process is the same. Okay. Yeah, I think probably 48 through 53, you'll see some repeated zeros in there and probably not in 36 through 43. But like effectively, the process does not change on what you're doing. You know what I mean? Just some of the weird things that can happen. You know, there's more weird things that could happen on 48 through 53. Okay. So today, plan for the class. Make your half sheet of notes. Work on the review and the or the problem set, whatever is kind of highest priority for you. And that's our plan. Everybody cool? Again, if you can't finish your half sheet today in class, like, God help you, I have 80 minutes to do that. Like, you should be able to accomplish that. But if you can't, you know, I take them up to tomorrow morning So once the first hour gets their tests, no more note sheets are we accepted. So first hour takes their test tomorrow morning. If you turn in your problem or your half sheet after that point, I will not take it. Okay? But if you need to turn it in after this class, that's okay. Just make sure you get it to me before first hour tomorrow. And if you have to email me a picture, that's okay. Right? Everybody's cool? You know what to do? All right. I'm going to get out of your way and let you get crack-a-lackin'.